Hey guys, it's Kristen, aka KNC. How are you guys doing today? I am doing a solo video this time, and I'm gonna be showing you guys how I give my dog a bath. She is a 2-year-old German Shepherd. Her name is Jewel. My dad named her, but I don't take the credit for it. But I'm gonna show you how I give her a bath at home. As you can see, I'm wearing my shirt that says Mary Fuel on it. I go to grooming school. I've been doing it since August. I have 2 months left of school. So hopefully I will get the experience of being a dog groomer if you guys need one. But I'm going to show you how I bathe my dog. I normally use the shampoo. I think it's the Tearless shampoo for her face. But we ran out of it a couple weeks ago and I have to go get more. But, give me that, please. Thank you. I use this on her body, which is an itch soothing shampoo, which is Bird's Bees. So I put this on for the first layer. And the second layer, I have a hypoallergenic shampoo. But I think I'm gonna put this one on first and then this one for the second. I normally have a Tearless shampoo, but like I said, I don't have it. I ran out of it a couple weeks ago. But she has never been in a tub like this before. I normally put her in the guest bathroom shower, but since I have to go in there with her, I decided that I'm gonna do her here because I have my grooming school tools with me. So that's why I have her choker attached to this noose right here that I use for school, so she doesn't move around all over the place. I especially don't want her to jump out of the tub. She has never been in a tub before, but like I said, I've taken her to school with me to give her a bath, groom her. So what you want to do first before a bath, I keep this on her so she doesn't go anywhere like she is right now. She's trying to jump out. I keep this on her to control her. And her thing just got loose. Let me just fix it. Because this, I can make it whatever size I want. See, it's like a buckle, so I'm gonna put that on first. And I'm just gonna put this little thing up right here so that way it doesn't go anywhere. Alright, so I keep this on, so I'm gonna take her flower collar with her name tag on it off. And then I'm gonna grab this. What I recommend you guys to do, I've learned this in school actually, it's better to wash the dog's body off first. Because if you do the body and the head at the same time, the dog will shake, you'll get soaking wet. So to get less soaking wet, you have to work on the body first before doing the head, which I'm going to do right now. She does have her flu medication on, but we put it on the back of her neck like 2 nights ago, so she should be fine with giving a bath. It only takes a couple hours for the thing to her medication to go on her skin for any fleas, ticks, mosquitoes. So that's why whenever we put her medication on, I usually wait 2 to 3 days before giving her a bath. But she only gets a bath like once every 2 to 3 weeks. Good girl, Jewel. Good girl. now I'm going to use the Itch Soothing. Yeah, Itch Soothing shampoo on her. You can put the shampoo on the dog's body, but to get underneath the dog, you have to put it on your hands and then scrub kind of like this underneath really deeply and really good. Get a towel from up here. You know, I don't want the camera to get wet, so I'm gonna move it over here just in case. Okay, there we go. But then you guys can't like see the work, so let me just move it this way a little bit more. It's on a rug, so let me see. Yeah, no, it's not going to hold, but I really like it to be up here where you guys can see. Apparently that's not going to work, so let me try. I'm gonna leave it up here for a little while. And I'm gonna stand up later on to finish her. So I'm gonna stand up right now to do it. I gotta do the other side. To get a good bath for your dog, I'm just sitting on the tub really quick. To get a good scrub in the dog's hair, you have to feel like that you're massaging the hair. Like if someone's giving you a massage, it's kind of like that. To get a good clean and good fresh smelling on the coat. Sorry, Joel, I'm gonna have to get in here with you. I was gonna give her a bath tomorrow, but I'd rather do it now because I don't finish school until 2:30 and I don't want to be there until like 3 and then the traffic gets bad from where my school is. So it's better getting her a bath now than later.
She does shed a lot. German Shepherds tend to shed a lot, especially when you're giving them a bath. That's make sure that her hair doesn't like clog the string. So now I'm going to get more shampoo and I'm going to do her tail. All right. So I'm going to use this on her tail now. I want her spin, but apparently she can't because of the noose. So I'm going to go to the other side behind the shower curtain and do her tail. Make sure you get a good scrub on the tail because it does get a little bit messy. And you might as well clean the dog's butthole after they go to the bathroom. I normally clean under her legs as well, where she pee-pees, and I clean the butthole after she poops. So I'm going to put a little bit on my hands for that. So I'm going to come this way, excuse me, baby. We'll just scoop it out here. No, stay in the tub. Stay in the tub. Good girl. Rinse her off. I just hope I don't get splashed with this. So this shower head is very strong. I'm just gonna, there we go. Right here in front of the shower, so I'm gonna move that forward. There we go. Come on, look this way. Come on this side. Stay away from the edge. Stay away from the edge. There you go. There you go, good girl, like that. If you don't have a rug, make sure the water doesn't like splash on the floor. And then you have to like get a towel. And I have no idea what just fell. Oh no. This fell out, okay. I don't care if I get wet because I'm kind of used to getting wet by other dogs at my school. So, if you're not used to it and you don't want to get wet, I recommend you wear a bathing suit or a trunk bathing suit if you're a guy, and just wear a t-shirt and shorts. Hey, baby. She sees my little shelf up here moving with a shower head. Let me just unhook it. There you Alright, so I'm just gonna go back here again and get the tail. I saw that coming. All right, let me get a small towel here. Oh. All right, so the only thing that's soaked are my tights, but I don't really care. All right, so now I'm going to use, let me just clean off this area right here so I can sit down. Okay, so now I'm going to use hypoallergenic shampoo for the second layer. Sorry, Mama. She's dying to get out of this tub, but that's not going to happen until you're done getting a bath. Next thing I'm going to show you guys is how to shampoo the face and also to dry off your dog with just a blow dryer. At my school, I have force dryers and stand-up dryers, but since I don't have them in my house, they're like over $1,000 just for one. Probably when I finish grooming school, I'm probably going to get one of my own. But for right now, I'm just going to stick with the blow dryer. Okay. I know, you want to get out of this tub. That's right, you're crying. You want to turn this way? Get out. Relax. You've gone to bath many times before. All right, so I'm gonna come over here. Just take a one step forward towards you. Like I said, she is only 2 years old. That's why she is crying right now. No. Under the armpit, under the arms, under the legs, I mean. They don't have arms, they have legs. Okay. Yeesh. This, dry off my hands. No, don't shake with the shampoo on you! Yeah. Now let's take the shampoo off. I'm actually not going to wash her head because I don't have any tailor shampoo, and I'd rather not wash her head than get shampoo in her eyes. So that's why I recommend you guys get the tailor shampoo for their face. Don't use the same shampoo they use on their body. Because if you do get shampoo in your eyes, then their eyes become red and you have to flush that out with contact solution. It takes like 30 minutes, maybe 40, to like give her a nice cool bath, but I'm only doing her body right now. And I'll do her face tomorrow at school because I don't have any tailor shampoo here. Her hair is probably clogging up the drain. I gotta get her hair out of the drain. I'm just gonna scoot this over so I can come over here. It's better to clean your doll with cold water rather than hot water. Thank you. guys the other side. Cool. See? No, I'm not stepping down with you. Alright, I'm gonna have to step in the tub with her because I can't reach the other side. Why I wanted to keep the camera far away so that way it doesn't get wet when she shakes. So that is it on how to give the dog a bath. The next thing I'm going to show you in the next video, because I don't want to make this video too long, I'm going to show you how to blow dry your dog without using a force dryer. So hopefully that will be posted up real soon, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!